I'm Dr. Frita, and I'm giving you 7 early warning signs and symptoms of kidney problems and what to do about it. Your kidneys are your 2 bean-shaped organs located in your lower back, where your love handles are. And I'm sure that you know that your kidneys are responsible for filtering out excess fluid from your blood and making urine. But did you know that if both of your kidneys fail, then you cannot live? Unless you have some form of kidney replacement therapy like dialysis or a transplant. Here's the thing. If you're able to recognize the early warning signs of kidney problems, in many cases, you don't have to progress to that point. You may never have to progress to needing dialysis or needing a kidney transplant. Over 37 million Americans have kidney disease and many don't even know it. 1 in 3 is at risk. So let me ask you this. If you could potentially prevent kidney failure or slow down the progression of having kidney problems, wouldn't you want to do it? Well, guess what? I'm a board certified kidney specialist, and today I'm giving you 7 early warning signs and symptoms of kidney problems and what to do about it. Keep watching. I am offering a concierge telehealth consultation service. So no matter where you are located in the world, you can talk to me, we can have medical conversations, and I can give you personalized information. Just make sure you click the link, you go to my profile, and you can set up your appointment today. I will talk to you and just really take my time and give you world-class health advice, not just generalized advice, but advice that is personal to you. I'm Dr. Frita, and I'm a board-certified nephrologist, which means I'm an MD who specializes in kidney disease and high blood pressure. And let's just talk about the kidneys. The kidneys are such vital organs, they're so important, yet I feel like they don't get enough attention. So yes, your kidneys are the 2 bean-shaped organs located in your lower back, and each kidney is about 9 to 11 centimeters in most people. You have 1 million nephrons in each kidney, which means you have 1 million little units responsible for filtering out your blood and cleaning your blood in each kidney. And it's really quite a powerhouse, you know, both of the kidneys are. They're powerhouse organs. So in addition to your kidneys making urine, okay, filtering out the blood and getting rid of excess fluid, they do so many other things. They help to balance your electrolytes, like your sodium, your potassium. They help to regulate your blood pressure. They even help to keep you from being anemic. And they're important for bone health and for vitamin D. The list goes on and on. The important thing to know is that if you don't recognize early warning signs and symptoms of kidney problems, then you can progress to kidney failure, where you actually need a dialysis or you need a transplant if you're going to live. And so today I want to talk about how to recognize these warning signs and what to do about it. So now, after you finish watching this video, I want you to tell me which of the warning signs of kidney problems stood out to you and why. Comment down below. The most common early warning symptom of kidney failure is nothing. That's right. I have so many people who come into my office and they say, hey, you know, my doctor says I have some kidney problems, but I make a lot of urine. I have energy. I feel fine. I look fine. And that's true. That's why it's so important that you see your physician regularly, because when you get your routine history and physical, that routine blood work will check your BUN, your creatinine, and it can pick up warning signs of kidney disease before you ever have any kind of symptom. And remember, signs are what you see, symptoms are what you feel. And so a warning sign can be picked up by your doctor even before you ever feel anything. 1, swelling or edema of the hands and feet. So your kidneys are responsible for helping to balance your electrolytes, including sodium. If your kidneys aren't working well, or if you have kidney problems, then you may be holding on to too much sodium, which will cause you to hold on to fluid, and you get a swelling in your tissues called edema. And so if you're getting swelling in your hands, swelling in your feet, your ankles, your legs, if you're noticing when you put on socks, they're leaving indentations or your shoes are getting tighter, this definitely could be an early warning symptom of kidney problems. Another issue is that if your kidneys are actually leaking out protein, You can get swelling in your whole body. You can get swelling under your eyes or around your eyes, periorbital edema. You can get diffuse edema or swelling everywhere. And you can have something called nephrotic syndrome. Number two, change in urination. Many people think that if they're making a lot of urine, that they couldn't possibly have kidney problems. Well, that's actually not true at all, because one of the early warning signs of kidney problems could actually be making a lot of urine. And this is why. Your kidneys are responsible for concentrating the urine that you make as it leaves your body or as you excrete it. And if you're having kidney problems, you could have difficulty concentrating your urine, which can make you have a very dilute urine and actually make you have polyuria or urinate a lot. You can even be getting up and using the restroom at night or having nocturia, and that could actually be a symptom of kidney problems. Also, if you're urinating frequently or having urinary frequency, that could be a warning of kidney problems. And men, if you have a large prostate, BPH, then this could cause you to have a urine urgency, meaning you gotta go right now. You get to the restroom, you don't really have to go. Or you can have urinary hesitancy where you're kind of dribbling or trickling out urine, but then you still feel full. All of this could be an early sign of kidney problems or an early symptom of kidney problems. And certainly, as you get advanced kidney disease, then you may actually have a decreased amount of urine or oliguria. So yes, a change in urination, whether it's urinating more frequently, making a lot of urine, or making a little urine, a change could be an early warning symptom of kidney problems. Number three, skin itching. A lot of people think that when their skin is itching, that maybe they have an allergy or they need to change their lotion or their soaps. That could be true, absolutely. But what is also true is that skin itching and even rashes can be an early symptom of kidney problems. So your kidneys are responsible for filtering out phosphorus. And phosphorus is something that is found in a lot of foods. It's found naturally, but it's also found in a lot of processed foods. And when your kidneys aren't working properly, if you have kidney disease, then you're not urinating out that phosphorus like you should. What happens? It builds up in your blood. You get hyperphosphatemia, high phosphorus in the blood, and it can cause an itching, an intense itching all over your body. It can make you scratch. You can also get certain rashes, and yes, there are numerous reasons for getting rashes. But just remember, if you have kidney disease, it can also be related to dry skin and rashes. Number four, fatigue. Fatigue or having low energy is really one of the trickiest ones, because so many different disease processes can cause you to be fatigued or just very, very tired. But don't forget that having kidney problems is one of them, and for many reasons. One, your kidneys are responsible for making something called erythropoietin, which stimulates your bone marrow to make more red blood cells. Basically, your kidneys functioning properly are important to keep you from being anemic. Well, if you have kidney disease and you're not making that erythropoietin, then you can become anemic or have low blood, which can lead to low energy and cause fatigue. Also, your kidneys are responsible for getting rid of excess toxins in your blood. So if your kidneys aren't working well, you get an excess BUN, blood urea nitrogen, or creatinine, and you can have other toxins that build up in your blood, and they can cause you to have very low energy. So remember, if you have fatigue, this could be a warning symptom of kidney problems. Number five, shortness of breath. When we talk about shortness of breath, many people go straight to the lungs. They're like, do you have asthma? Do you have emphysema, bronchitis, all of those things? And certainly those can cause shortness of breath. But having kidney disease or kidney problems can cause shortness of breath as well for a couple of reasons. One, if you are holding on to fluid, if your kidneys stop working well and you're not making enough urine, a backup of fluid in the lungs, okay, pulmonary edema can cause shortness of breath. Also, if you are leaking out protein in the urine and you have nephrotic syndrome or nephritic syndrome or some syndrome that's causing you to leak out protein, that will cause you to hold on to fluid. You can get fluid in your lungs. That can lead to shortness of breath. In addition to that, being anemic from kidney problems can lead to shortness of breath. Again, your kidneys are responsible for keeping you from being anemic or having low blood. If you're anemic, that's an issue because your red blood cells are like little donut-shaped cars that carry your oxygen to your cells. If you are anemic, then you're not getting enough oxygen. And so when you try to exert yourself, then you may become short of breath. So the next time you feel short of breath, instead of automatically assuming it's a lung problem, remember, shortness of breath can be a warning symptom of kidney problems. Number 6, low back pain. Now here's the interesting thing. Most of the time, chronic kidney disease does not cause low back pain. It doesn't. But there are cases when low back pain can be a warning symptom of kidney problems. For example, if you have a urinary tract infection that has progressed or ascended up to where you actually have kidney infection or pyelonephritis, that can certainly cause you to have a low back pain, and that's a kidney problem. And also, if you have kidney stones, oh my gosh, kidney stones can cause a low back pain that will make my biggest, roughest, toughest patients fall down to their knees and cry. Yes, low back pain can be caused by kidney stones, which is certainly a kidney problem that you don't want to deal with. Be sure to watch my videos on the painful truth about kidney stones and my video on kidney pain symptoms after you finish watching this video. It is important to remember that even though it is possible for low back pain to be a warning symptom of kidney problem, most of the time, again, you don't get low back pain just because your kidneys aren't functioning well. So it is going to be very important that you follow up with your primary care physician and you get screened before even waiting for a symptom like low back pain. Number 7, urinary tract infections. I get so many patients in my office who have recurrent or repeated urinary tract infections, and this could actually be a warning that there's a kidney problem. So you can get a bladder infection or a cystitis. That's a common urinary tract infection. And what happens there most often is that bacteria, or it could be some other pathogen like fungus or even a virus, but usually bacteria crawl up the urine tube or the urethra into the bladder. Now, with women, because the urethra is short, okay, the distance between the bladder and the outside world is short in women, they tend to get this cystitis or urinary tract infections more frequently. With men, because the distance between the bladder and the outside world has to go all the way through the male organ, well, it's harder for bacteria to crawl and make it all the way up to the bladder before a man urinates and gets rid of them. So if you get recurrent urinary tract infections, specifically recurrent kidney infections or pyelonephritis, this could certainly lead to kidney disease, but the recurrent urinary tract infections could also be a warning that there's something else going on with the kidney. For example, you could have blockage. If you are a man and you're constantly getting urinary tract infections, that's not really of the norm. And so you want to make sure you talk to your doctor about perhaps doing a kidney ultrasound or some imaging of the kidneys to make sure you don't have a big prostate that's causing a backup of urine, which is leading to your recurrent urinary tract infections. And also, for both men and women, if you're getting recurrent urinary tract infections, that can mean you have some type of a blockage or a tightening or a stricture somewhere in your kidney system, in the genital urinary tract. For example, if you have a narrowing in that urethra, that tube from the bladder to the outside world, that could be something that leads to repeated urinary tract infections. So yes, having urinary tract infections could be a warning that you have a kidney problem, and you definitely want to do something about it. So these are some of the early warning signs and symptoms of kidney disease. The list certainly is longer than that, but I want to know this question. Were there any warning signs that I mentioned that you were not previously aware of? Please let me know in the comments. There are many different causes of kidney disease, but it is key to recognize these warning signs and symptoms so that you can act early and prevent a progression to kidney failure. Yes, the number one cause of kidney disease is diabetes. The number two cause of kidney disease is high blood pressure in the United States. But there are other things as well, things that aren't such common knowledge. For example, certain medications can cause kidney disease. Also, if you get an overwhelming infection or a septic shock, that can lead to kidney disease. Dehydration. Yeah, not drinking enough water can lead to kidney disease. And then there are different genetic diseases, things you're born with, like autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease or IgA nephropathy or FSG, focal segmental glomerulosclerosis, IgA nephropathy. The list goes on and on. The key to kidney disease prevention is seeing your doctor. Remember, the most common early symptom of kidney failure is nothing. It's nothing. But when you go to your doctor and you get your routine history and physical, again, we do routine testing, We can check for your kidneys to make sure that you're not having kidney problems. And if you are, or if you have a family history of kidney disease, then your physicians can really guide you to prevent progression to kidney failure. I want you to be proactive, okay? I want you to take charge of your health. If you have more questions, or if you want to actually have your own personal history and physical reviewed, and you want to talk to me about kidney disease, I now am providing a concierge service where you can have a one-on-one consultation with me, and I will give you that undivided attention and give you my expert opinion on your kidney health. Be sure to click the link below to find out to have a concierge appointment one-on-one with me. If you found this video to be helpful and informative, please be sure to like it and to share it with the people you care about. As always, I appreciate your support. I appreciate you for watching, and I want you to do your best to live your healthiest, happiest life. I'm Dr. Frita.